All right, just make up your stinking mind. Are you staying or are you going? I need to know.
What, who are you, The Clash?
I need to know, Carl Edwards, whether you're staying or whether you're going.
Well, I will let you know in my own way, in my own time. I don't answer to you, Greg Biffle. I'm not beholden to you, Greg Biffle.
Well, you know what, Carl? Be a man. Step up and have some integrity and tell us what you're doing, okay? Because I am so sick and tired of sitting here and listening to all these people. Man, what's Carl going to do? What's Carl going to do? If you know what you're going to do, tell everybody and get it over with. I am sick and tired of the circus.
I need to be sure that what I do, look, this is probably going to be the last big decision in terms of my career I make. This is the biggest decision I am working towards that. But I am not going to rush for you, Greg Biffle.
What's to rush? Oh, yeah, that was scary.
Huh?
What's to rush?
See, have a little
Matt Gaetz. You've got choice A and you've got choice B.
Well, look.
You need to get your little blanket and sleep there with your little stuffed animal and think about it.
No, but check this out.
Make up your mind.
Obviously, my strategy is working. Because I had a really sweet deal proffered by Toyota and Joe Gibbs Racing. Now Ford has come out of the woodwork, and they've joined Roush Fenway Racing to try to match that deal and to try to keep me. So obviously playing one against the other is working.
It's all about the Benjamins with you. Well, let me tell you something,
I got
mister.
Kids I got to send to college.
Let me tell you something, Mr. Man. You have practically ruined your championship hopes for
this year.
Even if you come back, everyone's going to be so mad at you for jerking them around the way you have that your championship hopes are going to be totally kaput.
I just expanded my points lead. How can you say that?
You were lucky to expand your points lead. Frankly,
okay.
I was lucky to finish in the top 10.
Yeah.
Okay? So let's be honest about what's going on here. You were not in a good race car in Indianapolis because your team is not supporting you because you're not supporting them because you don't have the respect for them to come out and tell them what the hell you're doing next year.
So by that logic, that would suggest that your team hasn't been supporting you all season because you've had crappy race cars all season long.
I've had crappy race cars because I've had crappy race cars. You, on the other hand, are undermining your chance to win a championship, which you clearly have.
Dude, not yet.
I would like to see you succeed. Okay, I would like to see you succeed.
I would like you to see you get your braces off. That's what I would like to see.
If you want to succeed this year, you've got to tell everyone what you're doing. And you can't sit there on the fence dickering and dockering all season long.
I'm not on the fence. I am working it out. It sounds to me like somebody's got a lot of sour grapes that they need to deal with over there.
Sounds like someone's a little bit selfish. For Greg Biffle.
No, I'm Carl Edwards.
For Carl Edwards, I'm Greg Biffle. Should we hear what they really had to say?
Well, we could hear what, who did we have a quote from? We had a quote from Biffle, right? Let's hear what Biffle had to say.
For really, it'll be best for both companies or for everybody. So, you know, one, we can plan for sponsorship and drivers and teams and people. You know, there's a lot of people's jobs on the line. You know, if we're going to be three teams or four teams. So, you know, the sooner the better.
You sounded nothing like him.
Well, you know. I wasn't concentrating on the vocal performance. It was more the attitude
gotcha.
I was going for.
Okay. All right.
That's our take on the Carl Edwards contract situation, I guess.
No, it's their take.
Oh, right.
We were channeling.
Yeah, we were channeling.
Rowdy.com. Say it like it is.
Say what like it is?
Rowdy.com.